Welcome to Art Talk. I'm Patricia Shippee, your host of Through the Eyes of the Artist, a program that focuses on art from a human perspective by getting to know the artists, their attitudes, their motivations, even their lifestyles, all the things that influence their artistic expression, giving us an opportunity to see our world through the eyes of the artist. Today's guest artist is Frederick Walperswyler, who is visiting us from Geneva, Switzerland, and Brittany, France. Frederick is currently an artist in residence at the Griffis Art Center in New London, Connecticut, where he is staying for 9 months away from his usual life activities, purposely to focus on his painting. And we'll talk lots about his painting and what he's been doing here. Frederick was born in Neuchâtel, Switzerland, an area of beautiful lakes and mountains. He studied architecture and interior design and worked at this practical career for a number of years, but always drawing and painting. In the 1960s, he took a sabbatical from architecture and devoted himself solely to his sculpture and painting. Now, for a number of years, Frederick has been teaching drawing and sculpture at the School of Decorative Arts in Geneva. He has exhibited his work all over the world, certainly Switzerland, Japan, Germany, Canada, and now the United States. When Frederick applied to the Griffis Art Center, he offered the following statement, which I think clearly reflects who he is and his thoughts about life and art. And I quote, "Painting, creating, is to me a way to discover oneself, and at the same time, a way of meeting and discovering matter with all its potential. Moreover, it is like a hymn to life, a poetic way to discover and express its deeper sense. Two main existential necessities are always on my mind. One, doing art, painting and sculpting. Two, ocean sailing." Welcome to Art Talk, Frederick.
Thank you.
It's nice to have you here. And we're going to talk about what you've been doing here in the United States and what you did before you came here. But let's go back to the beginning. When you were a child, did you know that you had a talent for drawing? Were you encouraged to express yourself creatively?
When I was a child.
It's always interesting to me to know if, as a young person, you knew that you had this talent.
I have to say it's difficult to speak in terms of talent. What I would like to say, when I was young, with my father, with my mother, we used to draw together.
Ah.
I have to say, because it was a play. And but very young, I have to say, and I like to say, the direction of my way was not very, very clear, do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
And before I realized I had to do this profession, I like to use this word, perhaps more than the vocation. I like the word profession. Before it will be very clear for me.
Do you mean interior design or painting as a profession?
I know. No. I speak about what I am doing now. I speak art. I speak painting.
Mm-hmm.
I speak my heart life. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And it was not very clear, very young. But that came with the time, and more it was an obligation, I shall say, to do that.
Well, then, I understand that. When and why did you take this course to study interior design and architecture?
I think it was an approach of my today work. You understand what I mean? And
yes, I see a lot of design and theory of design, particularly in your paintings.
We can say that, perhaps, absolutely. Once more, I would like to repeat, for me it's a necessity to draw, and just for the pleasure, but it's also a necessity for my work to know where I am going in my work, you understand? And before doing a painting, I have to approach this work. You understand what I mean?
Yes. Well, now, the design aspect I can see very clearly in your work. The other thing that certainly is a major influence to your work is the sea, water. Tell us about that, and how did, why is water such an influence to you and your painting?
Why?
It's a heavy question.
Mm-hmm. We need a lot of time. Yes. Perhaps first, it's an existential question.
Yes.
Because I would like to say, during long years, I was not so comfortable in my mind, in my body. And I like to say, without the sea and without the painting, today, perhaps I shall be completely crazy or fool or dead.
Oh.
And thanks to the sea, thanks to the painting, today I can say I am enough happy, very happy, and I can see the way of my life. Therefore, the water and the sea was very, very important since I was very little, when I was kind. By example, I was sailing with my grandfather, with my father, and very early in my life, water was very important for me.
What did it give you, a sense of serenity and equilibrium and peacefulness, I suppose?
That's what you're
saying, And so you chose this because it did give you that sense of solitude as well, and you paint alone. So those things are connected. Frederick, I think we have to go now, suddenly, to your studio. I'm getting a signal here, and we'll see a little bit of the work you're doing now. All right, let's do that.
Thank you.
Frederick, your studio was so meticulous, your space and so spare, and your paintings are also very austere and spare. So it goes together for you, doesn't it? This environment.
You mean you speak about the order of my studio?
Yes, yes, yes.
Perhaps you know this is in relation with the big confusion of my mind.
Ah, yes, I understand.
It's interesting,
yeah, yeah.
Perhaps, yes.
So you need to have this
absolutely,
order.
Absolutely, I think so.
And your work has, although I could see the gestures and the rhythm in your work, it is also orderly. Certainly the format, too. Talk about format.
Mm-hmm.
Why the square?
Mm-hmm. If I speak about the format, I would like to speak just a little about my previous work, who was done in rectangles.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And at the time, my gestures was very, very were freer.
Mm-hmm. Much more abstract, as
absolutely,
I recall.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I would like to say, for me, it's also very important. This question of gesture is very important for me because, as you said, you know, I done some sculpture before.
Yes.
I was working in sculpture. And there, the pleasure was, in the same time, to have to work with my mind and with my body. Do you
mm-hmm.
understand?
Yes.
In sculpture.
Building.
Yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And in painting, the work is more intellectual, perhaps.
Mm-hmm.
We have to
mm-hmm.
be prudent when
yes.
we say that. But perhaps, and therefore, in front of the format, I need to move with my body. Do you understand?
Ah.
And this is the reason.
The gestures.
Yes, this is the reason I work in rather big format, because it's very important to have an action with my body.
Ah, so the rhythm. I think, Frederick, of writing, and I think also of being on the sea in your works, but I didn't understand the physical part. That's very interesting. Now, you also use the word intellectual, and I find in the meticulous aspect, in the spare, if you that word is good, I think, you're giving us an optical test. You're making me, you're making us, the audience who looks at your work, to think visually. Now, we have bands of color in these sweeping gestures. There's very little definition between them. Give me some idea of what are you after? What do you want me to think when I look at your work?
Sorry, can
what,
you
what? Yes. What do you want me, your audience, to think when I see your paintings? Do you have any idea of the visual, the eye, and the mind, what you want me to read, if you will, in your work?
If I want to propose you a special reading, you mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
Ah, big question, my dear.
sorry.
No, I would like to say, when I am painting, this is my question, and this is my problem.
Yes.
But when I give my picture to see, after, this is your question
uh-huh.
to read. This
uh-huh.
is the question of the viewer.
Okay.
This is also the reason. It was one of the reason I came into abstraction
mm-hmm.
because for me it was a way to offer more liberty for the viewer
mm-hmm.
to see my painting.
Mm-hmm.
Do you understand?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I do.
And I am very interested by words of the viewer because for me this is perhaps the work is really finished with my ideas and the ideas of the viewer.
Ah, okay.
You understand
okay,
what I mean?
And the response as well. Because you begin, you told me this, you begin, we have in your studio, we saw this white blank canvas, completely silent, and you go to it with what is your inspiration? What do you go to that blank with? What ideas? Dreams?
Oh, this is a lot of questions. This is, perhaps we can say this is dreams. When I enter in the white square, and this is dreams, but this is also all the questions about paintings, about sense of the painting, sense of colors, mm-hmm. Understand?
Yes, yes, I do understand.
Also, this is question about my gesture. Why today my gesture is the ones we saw.
Another one.
Yeah. You understand?
Yeah. This is Frederick, all these questions. We're going to speak about all of these things, but for a moment we have to take a short break and we'll be right back.
Mm-hmm.
Art is a process that fills our lives. See it, enjoy it. This public service announcement is brought to you by the Griffis Arts Center, New London, Connecticut.
Welcome back to Art Talk. I'm here with Frederick Walperswyler discussing his work. Before we go back to his studio and see some of his paintings there, Frederick, we were just talking about the gestures and the format, and the sizes, and the scale, and the colors. Why blue, and why the colors you use?
You used just before the word to spare?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Perhaps I shall use economy. I don't know if people can understand.
Economy is a good word. How can we define economy? Well, there's a purity, if you will, a simplicity. Is that
all to try to do the most with the less? Mm-hmm. You understand?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. First, this is perhaps the reason I used rather just the blue.
Ah.
And the blue, of course, the blue is my color. I meet the blue when I am on the ocean, when I am at sea. And I live really with the blue, you understand?
So it is your color. Yes.
This is my color. About colors, I would like to say you, when I was a child, we spoke a little before about the period when I was young.
Yes.
I would like to say you, when I was a child, when I received a colors box,
yes,
I was in the same times so happy but so embarrassed by all the colors, you understand? Because for me, just the box with colors and the little squares in the box, the picture was done. It was beautiful. And I didn't know what I could do with these colors. And therefore, I used to use just the blue, because it was water, it was the sky.
Yeah. And it was economical.
Already at this period. And the red for the heart, and the yellow for the light.
Ah, so those are the colors, the heart and the yellow. And sometimes white. Do you consider white to be a color?
Yes, and today, of course, yes, it's a big question, I have to say. When I have to speak about that with my students, this is a big question. Black and white, yes. Are colors or not?
Yes.
We know that black is all colors together, and white is no color.
No color. Yes.
But I prefer to say this is colors because I am using them, do you understand?
It's very important in your work, too,
yes,
because it adds to the rhythm, I think, and the musical aspect in your work. Does music have any effect on your work? Do you listen to music when you're working?
I need music, yes, I need music. I listen a lot to music. I would like to say you, with the pleasure to work here in America, for some reason, I listen less music working.
Interesting,
yes.
Yeah. Well, you've had so many influences here, Frederick, and I want to talk some more about your visiting New York and the art you see and so on. But first, we're going to go back to your studio now, and you're going to allow us to think with you as we view some of your paintings. We'll do that now.
What I am happy to look for in my squares, in my blue squares, as I like to say, it was and it is still the passage between colors, as we can see here. By a repeated gesture, I used to, after having painting in the figuration, and when I entered in my blue squares, it was a necessity for me to be very economical by the gesture and by the number of colors. And the reason of what we can see now are all that. I try to be the most experiences with the less gestures and less colors. Now we can see perhaps another one. In that picture, I was interested to work in relation, in connection with words, as we can see here, and like in the other pictures, my gestures painting is a gesture enough like the gesture of the writing. And therefore, arriving here in your country, in America, I was interested to work on the problematic between painting and writing. And I had the chance to meet a poet. And here we have a poem, which name is The Tide. And the tide is part of the symbol of different levels, I mean different levels of water. And in that pieces, first I began to write the words, and after I needed to put different levels of colors. And this is the reason we can see, perhaps it's not very easy to read this word, but perhaps first the word, and after another level of colors here, perhaps the sky, and after a different, not only one, several levels of colors for the squares. And very simply, this is the problematic and the play I would like to see also around this piece. We shall see after on other pieces what these pieces oblige me to do, and we can perhaps see another piece. I had to do that one, as I said, because when I wrote on the wood, on the first level words, when after I could to be happy with the one, the second, the third levels of colors, I had some fear to continue and to add the two squares, and therefore it was a necessity for me to do some other pictures and to try and to dance some experiences between the different levels of color. Therefore I done this one where I could situate the square in the picture. And we shall see in the other one that I should be obliged to do not only that one but some other one other. And I propose that we see another one in that style. As I said, here perhaps the same experimentation, always thinking about the words on the three, on the two squares we saw before, because it was a necessity for me to do several experiences before returning in the picture we saw before. What is interesting here, working on a very clear subject for me, I discovered some other very interesting things. I mean, here I discovered the idea, the concept of the window, of window, and also something very, very interesting, the concept of double discourse. And I was so happy to work on a subject and on the way of this research to constate that my vision, my way will more open. And from now, perhaps for the next pieces, we shall forget the words and we shall enter in another word in relation with window and double discourse, and we can pass to the next one. Okay. Always that question about the window, about the double discourse, with this preoccupation to be spared. What I discovered in that paintings was something about the sign, was something new for me. This is perhaps the symbol of the compass. I mean, perhaps here we are in the world of the sea in all my paintings, and we can perhaps here recognize, this is my lecture, the north, the west, the south, and the west here. I am sure that in the future I could take this image and I shall be able to use this sign perhaps to work about this symbol. Always with the preoccupation, I would like to insist, the preoccupation of the pleasure of the color. I spoke about to try to do the more with the less, like here, but I know also the pleasure we can find here with more paint, with more colors, by example. And we can see perhaps the last one. Perhaps I would like to say first about this picture. I like it. Modestly, I would like to say I like that one. Perhaps I like this picture for the symbol of the confusion we can read here. I am always in my problematic of, or in my subject of the window, of the double discourse, but here perhaps with more mystery for me and more confusion. And I have to say, perhaps I shall have the occasion to repeat this word, I am sure that we live in the confusion, and I am sure that it is when we are conscious of the confusion we can perhaps find something in it. And therefore, here, perhaps I can learn from the picture something more about the passages about I spoke at the beginning on the first pictures. I can learn a lot about passages between just colors. This is the experimentation with colors, but I can learn also about the confusion of signs between what could be a picture, a window, and what could be a sky, by example. And I like to travel between, once more, the front of the window, the behind of the window, and what happens also between the left and the right of that window. I have to say about this picture, it's not always the case, but I like when a picture continue after I have finished it, continue to bring me some information, perhaps, and we shall have the opportunity to speak about that, some dreams too. Okay.
That was really interesting, Frederick, and I see the intellectual aspect of your work, and it was a good opportunity for you to explain some of what you are doing with your painting. Writing and poetry are very important to you and your life. When did words become a part of your painting?
This year, perhaps.
Only.
I want to say on the picture. Of course, I was always in relation, in connection with words, of course. But when I came in America, when I had the chance to come here, after thinking about this question, I began to put words, but physical words, on my paintings, like we can see.
Yes, that we saw a few. Yes. So you had never done this before. This was a new aspect of the change of being here and having the opportunity. Well, you read a lot, and I know you read poetry a lot. And there was one in one of the catalogs that I saw of one of the exhibits you had in Switzerland, a particular cogent poem, short poem by Camus. And you, if you would speak it, it's just a few sentences, if one or two sentences in French, I can translate for our audience because I think it's appropriate.
Oh, this is a very, this is an idea, very important for me. In French, Camus said, j'ai toujours eu l'impression de vivre en haute mer, menacé au cœur d'un bonheur royal. If you can translate.
Yes, I will, Frederick. Camus, and it's never perfect again in English. I always thought of living on the open sea, threatened amidst a royal happiness. It's beautiful.
Oh, wonderful.
It's quite beautiful. Now, the words we now know. What about double discourse? What do you mean by double discourse?
Perhaps this is once more in relation with the confusion, perhaps. I don't know if I begin by the good way, but perhaps we can say that. I think, and some poets work about this question, also some director in movie, mm-hmm. I'm thinking about some of them.
Yeah.
I think when I speak with you, there is several languages. There is voice, there is my body language,
of course. Mm-hmm.
And I am sure, and we know that on the words, there is also something else. And this is the question when I speak about double discourse mm-hmm. paintings. There is the discourse of painting, and there is the discourse, by example here, of words. And we can find something in painting, in words, and between the two.
Yes.
You understand what I mean?
Yes, I think it has to do with the mind and the eye. The visual thinking is what I call mm-hmm. it. That's interesting, double discourse. Well, Frederick, we have many more words, but no more time. And so I'm sorry, we do have many other questions for mm-hmm. you, but we'll continue our conversation without the camera. But I hope you've enjoyed visiting with Frederick in his studio and having an opportunity of seeing his work right within your home and gleaning some insight about what does make an artist create, what are the things that make art so important to them and then to our lives. And so, thank you for joining us for this week's Art Talk. Until next week, thank you. I'm Patricia Shippee. Thank you.